No olvides que tenemos subtítulos en español.
Et nous vous rappelons que nous avons également des sous-titres en français.
Welcome to La Gazette!
Haute Couture Collections are right around the corner, but this season, for the first time, they will present online due to the pandemic.
We thought it was a perfect time to look back at the fall-winter prêt-à-porter runways and show your highlights from Paris Fashion Week, from a time back when we could still say hi with two kisses.
We'll show you our highlights in two parts. On this episode, you'll see the very first show of Coberni.
We'll join Carly Claus in the live show.
And you also see Marine Serre, who kind of predicted the pandemic.
And finally, we'll end the day with a walk by Gigi Hadid on Isabel Marant.
Stick until the end to see which designers we'll be covering next week.
Hope you enjoy it.
Hi, this is Gabi.
And I'm Lucia.
From La Gazette. We are here at Coperni and we're ready to see what's new with them.
Let's go!
Coperni took place in Station F, which is a massive startup campus in Paris. We sat down in the atrium, serving as a runway for the day, and the models started coming out. The Parisian brand was created by designers Sébastien Meyer and Arnaud Vaillant in 2013. Their previous experience in Balenciaga and Chanel translates their vision into clean, elegant silhouettes with a sporty side and complex tailoring. This season, they staged their first ever fashion show. Up until now, they had done brand presentations.
For this season, Coperni imagined his girls as futuristic entrepreneurs, arriving at their Parisian startup offices in slim tailoring, with original proportions like long sleeves or unexpected cutouts. The use of plastic gave the collection a 60s vibe, and there's always sexiness present at Coperni, but it's definitely an elevated and a formal kind of sexiness.
Next off, the Loewe show, which took place, like every season, at the Maison de l'UNESCO, very close to the Eiffel Tower. We can see Carly Claus making her entrance. This season, Loewe was one of the first shows to offer mask and gel. The Spanish brand was founded in Madrid in 1846, and it's one of the oldest luxury brands in the world. Its creative director is British designer Jonathan Anderson, who also has his own brand, JW Anderson.
This season, Jonathan foreshadowed the ideas that are resonating strongly with the industry after the pandemic. Fashion needs to change. He lamented that high fashion brands were no longer pushing boundaries, and he said he intended to bring that back. The looks he created this season were made to make an entrance. Unusual silhouette shapes with volumes, drapes, and ruffles placed in unexpected places, all in luxurious materials, such as light brocades, and many accompanied by crazy feather hats slash wigs. The idea might seem crazy, but the result was mesmerizing and poetic. Jonathan gives a shy walk to thank his guest, and we run to the next show. Glamocalypse.
The word Loïc Préjean used in a recent video to describe the style of French designer Marine Serre could not be more accurate. She's only 29 years old and already won the LVMH prize in 2017. Her designs are recognizable thanks to the famous Moon monogram, which she mixes with vintage clothing or recycled fibers, making her one of the most sustainable designers out there. Upcycling, which means using clothes that already exist to make new ones, accounts for 50% of her collections.
Another of her brand's icons are the famous anti-pollution masks, which seem to foreshadow the world pandemic we're in right now, and of course, are sold out everywhere. This collection, entitled Mind, Melange, Motor, is a continuation of her theme of post-apocalypse glamour, where you need protection from your surroundings and you find it in the form of an embroidered mask or a double-breasted tailored dress. You also have to use a bodysuit to protect your skin, even under ruffled cocktail dresses. There was a sense of practicality in all of the collection, which featured pockets hidden where you least expect, and everyday objects, such as water bottles and umbrellas, styled with formal wear.
The casting of this show was particularly diverse, not only in color but in age as well. It featured from children to runway veterans such as Amalia Pirelli. Her designs are becoming a reflection of the world we live in, where we must take care of ourselves, but we don't forget the importance of beauty. And from one French designer to the next, we skip to our last show of the day.
The woman you picture when you try to imagine the style of the modern Parisian was created by Isabelle Marant. The French designer has been making clothes since she was 16 years old. Since then, the brand has developed an unmistakable DNA that mixes the 80s with boho and is, above all, quintessentially Parisian. Thanks to the collections maintaining the same style, her clients are able to mix pieces from different seasons and recreate looks of effortless cool time after time.
For her fall-winter collection, she opted for a minimalistic version of her aesthetic. The big shoulders were omnipresent in a palette of neutral colors. Heavy knits and coats alternated with party dresses, all with very marked waist, often accentuated with a belt. In great contrast with her spring collection, where the models were definitely going to the beach, these girls are staying in the city and protecting themselves from the cold. To complete every look, models wear the iconic marron pointy boots.
Shows we share with you today as much as we do. Next time, we'll give you a review of drumroll please.
Nina Ricci, Lanvin, Celine, and we'll drop by a book signing to meet none other than Kaya Gerber.
So hit subscribe down here to get notified when we post our next video.
And don't forget to follow us on Instagram and TikTok for more fashion.
Thanks for watching.
See you next time.
Welcome,
I'm gonna get him. No, you don't get much noise, it's a rapier. Yeah, that's it.